Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how to install and set up Google Drive for desktop. Now, if you haven't used this before or haven't heard of this, this can save you a lot of time. What it does is puts a folder on your computer that directly connects to the cloud to your Google Drive. So you don't have to open up your browser and log into Google Drive to access your files. It's always up to date on your computer. The other thing I like about this, if you're working in Microsoft too, if they're on your computer, when you open up those files that maybe are stored in Google Drive, they'll open up right away to the correct Microsoft app if they're on your computer. So today I'm going to go through installing and the setup of how to use Google Drive for desktop. I'll put the link to this download page for Google Desktop here down below in the video description. You can see it's either going to be for PC or Mac. I'm on my Windows computer here today. I'm going to go ahead and click the download. It's a fairly quick download, and then we'll start the install process. I'm just going to go ahead and open it right from here. And so we'll get ready for our install. I'm just going to say yes to this. And now at this point, and add an application shortcut to your desktop. You can have it there. I'm going to say yes for this and install. You can see it runs through very quickly to get it on your computer. So once it gets to this point here, we need to sign in with a browser. So I'm going to go ahead and connect it to this account right here. Hit sign in and it's success. So where is this going to show up? Well, let me open up my Explorer window here down below. I'm going to go and just open this up. And what I want to point out to you now is that we have this Google Drive here. I'm going to go ahead and open up this Google Drive and then go to My Drive, and you can see all these files. So where are these coming from? I'm just going to change this window and do a little side by side here. So this is my Google Drive online. If you take a look at this folder here, linking sheets and spreadsheets and Google Sheets, this is over here. If I open this up here, you see these different ones. If I open this up, you see the same ones. Now there's some choices that you can be making between streaming and mirroring, and I'm going to show you why you might want to choose either of those in a bit. But it's very easy to use this Google Drive for desktop, because all you have to do now, anything I drag into here will automatically get synced with here. So then I could be logging in somewhere else on a different computer, and I could just go and grab from my normal logging into the browser. So let me show you how these things can sync now. So if I go ahead, and you notice I have Google Drive up here because I have it in my quick access, and I also have it down here. It's the same thing, just two different places to get it. But let's say I was going to drag a picture out of here. So right out of these pictures, I'm going to go to camera roll. If I go and take this here, and I'm just going to drag it down into where it said My Drive, underneath Google Drive here. So if then I'm going to go ahead and open it. Notice now that it's right here. So if I go over to my browser, and here it is. So the same picture just got updated. It's synced here. So I can open up the picture here, and it is also here. Now, if I go and create a file from here, so let's say if I was creating a Google Slides presentation, I could go ahead and make this, and I'll just give this a little test name here, and I'm gonna go and just put a zero here, so it comes up right at the top of it, just like this. And so at this point, if I go back to my Google Drive, you're gonna see that this should be in my Google Drive over here. I'll just give it a quick refresh. Here it is, zero test. Now over here, and sometimes it can take a moment or so, but before the syncing is going in. But even if I just go in and then back out, you can see here it is, zero test. And if I go ahead and open it from here, it opens in, you can see it open in the browser over here, because that's what it was created in. Now, if I was creating something like Microsoft Word, so I have a Microsoft Word file that I would save into here. If I go to my Google Drive here, you can see that it is right here. And the issue would be if you want to keep on working in Microsoft Word from here, if I go ahead and open, I'm not going to get it to Microsoft Word. This is just going to be converting it into using Google Docs. But if I open it over here now, if it's saved, this is going to be saved in Google Drive, it's still going to open the Microsoft app on my computer. So thinking about, you can just drag things over into the folders. If I go ahead and make a folder, if I was making a folder over here, so if I go just go new folder, and you can see I'll just call this test like this, and I'm going to go back over here to my Google Drive, and I'll just do a quick refresh. Here is that folder, and then I can be moving things over here, and it's going to reflect over on this one. So if I go to test over here now, sometimes it takes a second. I'll just go back out again and in. Oops, click the wrong one. Go back, and you can see there it is right now. So it just took a few seconds to sync over, and now I moved it over here, but is reflecting over here. So I hope this helps you understand how the files are being moved around, how you can store, you know, I gave the example of Microsoft, but it can be other files too. If you're using Photoshop and you needed to open up a Photoshop file, it could be saved in here, and it will just open up Photoshop to do that. So let me go over now some of the settings that we can be using in this Google Drive for desktop app, such as mirroring versus the streaming. To access the settings on the Google Drive app, just go down to the bottom of the computer, bottom right hand corner. You can see here is the Google Drive app. I'm going to open this up. This shows me the activity, the things that I was just showing you from creating or moving the files and how everything is syncing. There are notifications to let you know. In this case, you can see this the action couldn't be completed, and it will just have different notifications there. Where I want to go to though is this right here. So I'm going to hit this little gear to go to preferences. Inside preferences, you can go ahead and add more files to or folders to backup on your computer. So this is a great feature if you have important files, you just want to make sure that you have a place you're backing up to the cloud that's not automatically in that My Drive, that folder that was syncing with Google Drive that was automatically added at the beginning. So if I go add a folder, and let's say something in my documents here, and let's for example Camtasia, all my different videos that I make using Camtasia, I want to make sure that these are saved to the cloud. I could go ahead and select this, and this will be synced with Google Drive. If it was going to be images and videos, well, then I would probably look at doing backup to Google Photos. You have a choice there. And then all you'd have to do is hit done at this point, and then it's going to sync. So depending on how much time or how many files or how big it is, it could take some time to sync everything back and forth. Now, what I want to point out is if we go to Google Drive here, when we originally set up Google Drive, it's under stream files, and this is going to save space on your computer because when you go ahead and select stream files, store all of my drive files in the cloud only, access files from the virtual drive on your computer. Now if you wanted them actually saved on your computer also, we could put the mirror files here. The one thing to know, when you do choose mirror files, this is going to take up more room on your computer because they are stored there, but if you weren't online, you would still be able to access those files from here because they're saved on your computer. So you choose what one would work best for you if you're worried about not having enough space on your computer. If not, you could go ahead and mirror. The other things I just want to point out right up here, notice that I can add another account right through this point. So if you did want a second Gmail account, Google Drive account, you can go ahead and do that. If I go to the gear again, you're going to see a few different options. So this is where I can disconnect the account that I'm set up with. You can see this is the one that I started and logged in with. If this is a good feature to have on, if you are using Microsoft Word, you can see if someone else is editing a shared Microsoft Office file. So if you check that, that would be on here. So the other thing with this one, do you want the letter G as your Google Drive? I kind of also leave it the same, but if you wanted a different letter, maybe you're using the G Drive as something else, you can go ahead and select it from right here. There's some other different settings that you can go through and check out here to kind of get everything just the way that you want. So go back to level if there's anything to add to backup right through here. So I hope you like this little kind of demo of setting up how to install the Google Drive for desktop app and kind of how it works with the streaming, or maybe you want to choose mirroring. I find this saves me a lot of time to have this on my computer. I have it on my Mac also. Then I can just be working back and forth from my computer without having to go to the web and open up Google Drive and logging in there each time. So let me know if there's any problems with anything down below in the descriptions and what else you're wanting to look at. I did have a different video about using Google Drive with just the online. I'll put a link to that one down below and in the card above. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.